Yeah, and one point here that I wanted to make for Josh, a long time ago in the early stages of talking about messaging, somebody had proposed the idea of being able to message anyone by knowing their Ethereum public address. And with this implementation, that is not possible. You need to know their origin messaging public address. And so this is stored in a publicly visible registry.
But that registry, you can map from the Ethereum address, basically. So you can take the Ethereum address and figure out what their public key address is. But yes, you need to at least enable messaging before you can actually start talking to people.
Basically. Yeah, that's what I mean, is that a person would have to have gone through this process and generated this key in order to receive a message.
Yeah.
Yeah, that makes sense.
Signing this, and mm-hmm. it will take me back to the dApp. So now if I go back and look at my global keys, yeah?
Yep. So that's you're there, and you're available, and and you can't, there's nobody else to converse with, because it's like, you know, you can actually use origin messaging that can converse, and they'll tell you who you can converse with, but right now there's nobody in there, so you can't converse with anybody, basically. Yeah.
Well, and actually I could put your address here.
Yeah, you can put my address, but I'm not there, so it would be false. Okay, so then you could look at my side, and so by the way, there's zero servers running right now, just talking to each other's WebRTC. So we are discovering each other ad hoc, basically. And we're actually on different Wi-Fi networks. I am on Bespoke Coworking, and Mike, I believe you're on Bespoke Guest. Let's see if we can discover each other or not.
Yeah, he's really rolling the dice with this one.
Well, you know, who knows? This is the nature of our demos, right? So now we can see that, like, here's everybody who's conversing. And actually, if you look at this address, this is not my address. This is actually Micah's address. So I actually found Micah on the network, even though, like, you know, neither of us put each other's IP address in here, and we're actually on different Wi-Fi networks. So that's one thing. And then, messaging, can I talk to Micah or not? So here, I can talk to Micah, but the thing is, I haven't signed my certificate yet. So he actually can't talk to me, but I could talk to him. So I want to start conversing. I would just say, okay. Jesus.
Yeah, mine still returns false on my end.
Yeah, but I haven't started yet. So, okay, can you see my screen? So this is the one step, two step. And now I should be ready for conversations, basically. And if you look at my key, I have both sides. And Micah, can you show off your side?
Yeah, okay, so now I'm back on mine.
And you should be able to see me, basically.
True.
And you converse with me. Yep, so you can talk to me, and then you can send me a message, basically. This is send conversation message, and yeah. And then you can say, you know, whatever you want to say.
Now, why don't we show your screen?
Okay, we got a message, and it says, this is a test. And that's the one from Micah, basically. And then, I could show off, like, you know, what happens if I'm not here. Should I show that off?
Sure.
Okay. And then if I close my window, Micah could still send me messages. And then, Mike, can you send me a message?
I guess I'd love to.
Okay, I'll pop this. So you just send me a message, and I'll restart this again, basically. I don't want to keep throwing presenting, basically.
Okay, I sent one.
Okay, so let's see what Micah sent me. And then, yeah, this is just showing off the WebRTC side for this stuff. And we got a message, and this is a test. Wait, is that the one you sent me or no?
No, you should have another one.
Huh?
That's all right. We got 90% of it.
Can you send me another message? I'm just kind of curious. It's like, yeah. Are we actually connected now?
Yeah, you're 6273, right?
Yeah. Just send another one, basically.
Yeah, let me change the message to see if that matters.
I don't think it matters, but like, I actually should get both. This is weird.
Well, and now I'm getting a RTC peer connection thing, so let me refresh.
Oh, your RTC probably died for a second. So this is actually without a backend server. What you would call, like, it's almost, you can think of it as a triangle. Oh, there, we got both the messages now. So you restart it, basically.
Yeah, so just refresh.
Your connection probably just died on us, basically. And this actually shows, the two messages that you sent me. So I got two messages coming back from you. So these are the messages you sent, and then, oh, this is another one. I guess you sent a third message? Okay, so you sent a total of four messages. And you can, we can see the messages in terms of, like, here's all the messages from, here's the 821, right?
Yeah, that's me.
Here's all the messages from that ETH address. This is all the decrypted messages from each side. Message is a test. You can see that this is the decrypted side. And you can also see what's actually sent on the wire, basically. And here's all the raw ones. And so, yeah, you can see that this is all the encrypted stuff. The key is encrypted data. It has IV. Although this is the key itself, this is the encrypted key. This is the asymmetrical encrypted key that's exchanged on both sides. And the message itself is encrypted as well, basically.